Hello friends, in this video I am going to show you the DC blocking property of the capacitor in multisim. Okay, so you know that the impedance offered by the capacitor is nothing but 1 by j omega c. Now for DC, this omega value is how much? 0. So if you substitute omega equal to 0 for DC, the impedance offered by the capacitor when DC voltage is applied will be 1 by 0, that is nothing but infinity. Okay, so impedance is infinity means obviously this path is open. So obviously the capacitor will not allow any signal to pass, that means it will block the DC signal. Okay, but if you consider AC signal, it has some, all AC signal has some particular certain fixed omega value. So if you put that, it will not go, the capacitor impedance will not go to infinity, and so that we can conclude that it will pass the AC. So this is one easy concept, easily explainable way that why capacitor blocks DC and passes the AC. So basically what will happen, suppose you are applying one DC signal here, it may be, suppose let me consider 12 volt, okay, and what you do, you keep one capacitor, okay. So what will happen, capacitor will block the DC. Now if you take the output across the resistor R, what will happen, across the R you will get voltage as 0 volt, okay, because capacitor is blocking the DC. So this is what the DC blocking property of capacitor. Let us directly go to multisim and check whether we are getting this output or not. So what we should get, we should get the output across the resistor as 0 if we provide only DC voltage as input. So let me check, let us check this. So see, this is the simple circuit whatever I told I have implemented. Just I have to place one capacitor obviously, because that is the main component of today's discussion. So capacitor, let me take one and place it here, and let me connect the capacitor. Just change the color of the output waveform, otherwise you will be unable to understand what is input and what is output. Okay, so generally we take output as blue and input as what, red, right? So basically see, output is, that is B probe is there for taking the output across the resistor, and we are providing input as DC. Let us run the simulation. So according to theory, we should get across the R1 voltage as 0. So let us check, see what is happening. See, let me make both as DC because we are applying DC only. So pause the simulation and see, here I told according to our circuit the input waveform is red in color, so red we can see, but where is the blue? Basically blue is superimposed on the this x-axis, that is y equal to 0. On y equal to 0, it is superimposed. If you change the y position of the channel B, you can see that this is the blue waveform. Okay, so basically what is happening, you just take the probe and see, place it anywhere. So see, now what you can observe, that the input, that is the red waveform, has the amplitude of 12 volt, but see the B, at channel B, it is providing minus 10.658 femtovolt, that means almost equal to 0. This voltage is basically noise only, okay. So basically minus 10.658 femtovolt what we are getting, okay. That means channel B is giving output voltage as 0. That means across the resistor output voltage is 0. That means the capacitor is not allowing any DC signal, okay. That is whatever we have studied in theory, exactly matching with our simulation. Now what I will do, I will just add one AC signal in the input side, okay. That means my circuit will look like this. What I am going to apply, I am going to apply AC plus DC in the input. So what I should get across the resistor as an output, obviously only the AC signal we should get. So let us check in multisim. So see, just I have added one AC signal, AC input source in the input side, and same circuit. Now let us run the simulation and see what we are getting. So obviously here both will be, if you take DC, let me take now see what is happening. This is input waveform which is red in color, this is output waveform which is blue in color, fine.
Now see, input waveform is always at higher amplitude compared to output waveform. Can you tell why? See, one thing is you can notice that input waveform oscillation is same as output waveform oscillation. That means whatever the AC part of the input waveform, it is same as almost same as output waveform. But see, input waveform is always at higher height compared to output. If you take the cursor in better way, you can understand. See, input waveform channel A is providing, okay, let me take at peak, then it will be more clear. See, channel A is providing 12.999 volt, and channel B is providing, that is output is providing 977.435 millivolt. That is, see, 12.999 volt as input and 12 volt is DC signal. That means AC is 0.999 volt, that is 99.9 millivolt. And in channel B, we are getting the AC as 12.999 volt, right? 12 volt is DC, that means obviously 0.999 volt is nothing but the AC waveform, that is 999 millivolt AC waveform we are getting in this instant in the input, and see in the output 997.435 millivolt you are getting. So the AC part of the input and the output, output is only AC obviously because capacitor is blocking the DC, so obviously the two AC parts is going to be same, okay? But see, the channel A is 12 volt more compared to channel B. Why the 12 volt more is there? Because in the channel A, that is in the input, we are providing 12 volt DC also, but due to the capacitor action, as the capacitor blocks the DC, so 12 volt lesser value we are getting in the channel B. That means in the output it is blocking, we are not getting the DC, okay? That's what I want to conclude by this simulation. But see, the AC is almost same. In the 12.999 volt, the AC is 999 millivolt, and in the output we are getting 977.435 millivolt. That means almost the same AC voltage we are getting, whereas compared to input, the output is 12 volt lesser because the capacitor is blocking the DC signal. Okay, so this is the basic simulation where you can visualize that, okay, the capacitor blocks the DC signal, and this is very important concept in many electronic circuit design. Like in most of the amplifiers, what we do, just if you, I will show you the exact part. If you remove all these things, see this part only, capacitor and then resistor, we take output across this circuit, okay? So in most of the amplifiers, what we do, we use multi-stage amplifier. Suppose our target gain is 100, okay? Now you made a design where the one single stage amplifier can provide only gain up to 20, then to get gain up to 100, so we have to use the gain of amplifier with 20 five times, okay? So five series connection, basically we can say five back to back connection of the amplifier we have to use to get gain of 100 from gain of 20 amplifier, right? So basically when we are using multi-stage amplifier, what is the problem? From one stage output we are providing as input of the next stage, right? So in this case, what should not happen? We design our amplifier, we first bias our amplifier to a particular Q point, right? So we should not disturb the DC operating point, otherwise it may go to saturation region and cutoff region and it will not perform proper amplification action, okay? So basically when the output of a particular stage is going as input of the next stage, no DC signal should be there in the output of the particular stage, so that if you don't filter it properly, if you just apply both the DC and AC output from one stage to the next stage input, what will happen? The DC output may hamper the DC operating point of the next stage amplifier, okay? So in those cases, in the amplifier, we use this type of circuits which you will study in detail in analog electronic circuit as what? Coupling capacitor. Okay, it will couple one stage amplifier to the next stage. So this is also called coupling capacitor. So the basically this property of the coupling capacitor, or why we use this, that is nothing but the DC blocking property of the capacitor. It will block the DC from one stage to another stage so that the DC operating point does not hamper for the next stage. Okay, so this is how you can visualize the DC operating point, the DC blocking property of the capacitor, and this is very important concept in the electronic circuit design. You will encounter this concept in detail in analog electronic circuit. So whenever you will come across to this term coupling capacitor, so you should keep this concept in mind that coupling capacitor is nothing but based on the DC blocking property of the capacitor, and it just blocks the DC and it allows the AC. It should allow the AC. If you use such a component which does not allow the DC and AC both, then what is the use of multi-stage amplifier? One stage output cannot go to next stage input, right? So basically you should use such component which will block the DC so that the DC operating point of the next stage never hampers, but the AC signal should be passed so that that component, electronic component, is nothing but the capacitor. Okay, so we design the capacitor properly according to our design of the amplifier circuit. Okay, so this is what all about DC blocking property of capacitor. Please keep this concept in your mind, because as an electronics engineer point of view, you should have a clear idea on the designing aspects, and obviously when you are designing some amplifiers, you should encounter coupling capacitor. Okay, so this is all for this video. Thank you for watching.